Typhoid fever can usually be treated successfully with a course of antibiotic medicine. This treatment can be done at home when diagnosed early, but you may need to be admitted to hospital if it's severe. In this video, we will talk about 1. Home treatment. 2. Hospital treatment. 3. Reappearance of symptoms after treatment. 4. Becoming a carrier. 5. Appropriate antibiotics. Please note that the treatment we are discussing in this video is the standard hospital treatment that should be prescribed by your doctors. 1. Home treatment. If typhoid fever is diagnosed in its early stages, you don't need hospital admission, thus you can take your drugs from home. A course of antibiotic tablets may be prescribed for you. Most people need to take these for 7 to 14 days. Your symptoms should begin to improve within 2 to 3 days of taking antibiotics. But it's very important you finish the course to ensure the bacteria are completely removed from your body. Make sure you rest, drink plenty of fluids, and eat regular meals. You may find it easier to eat smaller meals more frequently rather than 3 larger meals a day. You should also maintain good standards of personal hygiene, such as regularly washing your hands with soap and warm water, to reduce the risk of spreading the infection to others. Contact your doctor as soon as possible if your symptoms get worse or you develop new symptoms while being treated at home. A small number of people with typhoid fever have recurring symptoms. This is known as a relapse. Most people being treated for typhoid fever can return to work or school as soon as they start to feel better. Before we proceed to hospital treatment, please subscribe to our channel so that you can get notified when we release a new video on how to stay healthy. 2. Hospital treatment. Hospital admission is usually recommended if you have severe symptoms of typhoid fever, such as persistent vomiting, severe diarrhea, or a swollen stomach. As a precaution, young children who develop typhoid fever may be admitted to hospital. In hospital, you'll have antibiotic injections and you may also be given fluids and nutrients directly into a vein through an intravenous drip. Surgery may be needed if you develop life-threatening complications of typhoid fever, such as internal bleeding or a section of your digestive system got perforated. This is a very serious life-threatening complications, but this is very rare in people who started treatment early with antibiotics. Most people respond well to hospital treatment and improve within 3 to 5 days, but it may be several weeks until you're well enough to leave hospital. Now let's go to the third thing we want to explain. Reappearance of symptoms after treatment. This is what we call relapse. Some people who are treated for typhoid fever experience a relapse, which is when symptoms return. If this happens, the symptoms usually return around a week after antibiotic treatment has finished. This second time infection usually have milder symptoms and last for a shorter time than the original illness, but further treatment with antibiotics is usually recommended. See your doctor as soon as possible if your symptoms return after treatment. Becoming a carrier. After your symptoms have passed, another poo sample should be tested to check if there are still Salmonella typhi bacteria in your poo. If there are, you may have become a carrier of the typhoid infection. This means the Salmonella typhi bacteria continue to live in your body and can be spread as normal in poo or pee, but you will not have any noticeable symptoms. It's possible for the bacteria to live in your body for 12 months or more after you first became infected. You may need to have a further 28-day course of antibiotics to flush out the bacteria. Until test results show that you're free of bacteria, you need to be careful when handling or preparing food. It's also very important that you wash your hands thoroughly after going to the toilet. Appropriate antibiotics. Appropriate antibiotics are the only effective way to treat typhoid, though supportive measures such as oral or intravenous hydration, blood transfusions, and surgery may be required depending on the severity of disease and presence of complications such as intestinal perforation or bleeding. Appropriate antibiotic refers to administering the correct drug, correct dosage, and correct duration of treatment. This is key to treating typhoid with minimal complications. Depending on the antibiotic used, treatment lasts between 5 and 21 days. The family of antibiotics called fluoroquinolones like ciprofloxacin are now widely regarded as the optimal treatment for typhoid because they clear symptoms more rapidly, have very low rates of post-treatment carriage, meaning that it is less likely for a patient to continue spreading the disease following completion of treatment. These drugs are inexpensive, widely available, and generally well tolerated in both adults and children. Unfortunately, research shows that resistance to these antibiotics is becoming increasingly common. This forces the use of newer, more expensive, and less readily available antibiotics, including the group of antibiotics referred to as the third-generation cephalosporins like ceftriaxone. In the past, the first-line antibiotics for treatment of typhoid are chloramphenicol, ampicillin, and cotrimoxazole. However, typhoid strains resistant to these first-line antibiotics has been seen since the 1970s. So chloramphenicol, ampicillin, and cotrimoxazole are no longer used in the treatment of typhoid. Now that you know how to treat typhoid, you need to know what to eat and what not to eat. Watch the next video for that. Because treatment is becoming more difficult, there is need for increased access to preventative measures, such as vaccines and improvements in water sanitation, and hygiene becomes more urgent. We have a video on this and we will add the link to it in the description below. We have explained typhoid vaccine in details in our video on typhoid prevention. The link will be added to the description below. Please subscribe to our channel to know when we post an update on this. You are watching Zoom Hospital Channel and listening to Work of Dr. Kayode. Thanks for watching.